Now we're going to go over the components of the DTG. We need to remove panels to do this. Before we begin though, whenever you remove any panels that's going to be near any circuitry, it's a good idea to go ahead and unplug the machine. We don't want any power going through any of these circuit boards and run the risk of the metal cabinet touching a metal component or an electronic component and shorting systems out. All right, the majority of components on the DTG are going to be on the control panel side. So we need to start with removing this black panel. There are 9 screws that hold this panel on. Starting with the front side here, we need to remove the screw that holds the tray bed lock. We need to just remove the screw and the whole lock assembly. We have 1 screw down here at the bottom. We've got 4 screws along the side here. Just like in the front, we have a screw down the bottom and a screw holding the tray bed lock on. Remove the whole lock assembly. And the last screw is in a location a little difficult to get to, so we need to gently push the tray bed all the way into the ejected position. And then we have access to this last screw. Now the panel's free. And we just gently lift up. Now to gain access for the plumbing underneath the area, that's everything under the printhead, from the capping station down, we need to remove this ink splash guard. There's 2 screws, one here, and the other one under these wires here. So be careful not to pinch or crimp any wires. And then remove the splash panel. All right, let's begin by talking about the bridge unit. This is the area that the printhead travels back and forth on. Of course, you see the rails here. These are the rails that the head carriage slides back and forth on. That, of course, in your maintenance, you'll see needs to be oiled periodically to keep a nice smooth glide going on the printhead. Now, if we look down in here, we have the belt drive. This belt drive drives the printhead carriage back and forth. Right above that, we have the encoder strip. This little plastic strip is a data strip that the printhead carriage reads in order to orient itself, in order to know where it is. You may notice when the printer's booting up and going through its slow cycle of moving across, it's actually detecting that encoder strip and mapping everything out. Now this encoder strip also is part of your maintenance. This encoder strip will develop a mist of ink on it over time, and it needs to be cleaned periodically. In our monthly maintenance, we recommend once a month we clean that with a damp cloth, something that's not abrasive. If you notice here, we have a spring that keeps that encoder strip spring-loaded, so we always want to wipe from this direction moving that way. If we go from the other direction, we could pull on the spring and cause the encoder strip to come off of its post that holds it in place. Of course, we talked about the printhead carriage. Underneath the printhead harness here, the ink harness that actually brings ink into the printhead, we've got a little hood that it mounts to, and tape that holds that hood in place. If we peel that up, we can swing this little hood up and we can see down inside here. These little white things are the dampers. The dampers are basically a filter. They will filter out any impurities that are in the ink as well as any air bubbles that might get in the line. There's a little pocket of air at the top, so any air bubbles just go in and go to the top instead of going down. Now, if you do get enough air in a line, it could drain the damper and you will lose prime in the printhead for that color. All right, now we're going to talk about the drainage, the area underneath the printhead. This is the area, of course, where any of the waste ink is going to go down through this area and down into the waste tank. First, we'll talk about the capping station. That's this rectangular piece here. And as the printhead moves over, it engages it, which causes this rectangular area to form a seal with the printhead. If you look in the center area, this is a sponge, and any ink that goes through here will then go down through a tube down to the waste bottle. This area around the rectangle is actually a little rubber seal or a gasket. Now, when the printhead comes and docks and moves this up, it actually forms a seal on the face of the printhead so that it can actually draw and suck ink through there without any pressure loss. When you need to clean this area in your maintenance, the rubber rim around here is something that definitely needs to be cleaned. Ink will build up on that. Sometimes the ink will even look like the rubber itself after it dries. Also, to put a little bit of a cleaning solution on this capping pad here helps the ink residue from building up on this and creating something harder for the ink to draw through. Over here we have the wiper. This wiper, during the printing process or during a head cleaning, will actually move over here to this area so that when the printhead then leaves the docking station, it wipes the face of the printhead, keeping that area clean. Now, it will leave a residue around the edges of the printhead, which in your maintenance, you'll see you need to go in and clean around that edge of the printhead. The last thing down here is this black area with this tube, a clear tube with a green stripe. This is our actual printing pump. This pump works in conjunction with the printing process. When the printhead comes over to the dock every now and then, it will draw ink through, maintaining a printhead prime, keeping the ink filled throughout the printhead and no air getting in there. As well as this pump working in conjunction with that process, over on the other side, we have our waste pad, which the printhead goes over and spits a little bit of ink into. Now, this pad in here, you see the little marks of ink that it's actually spit out there. When you get the machine new, there's going to be two pads in here, so there'll be one even higher. It's not as important as, you know, as if it were Epson ink going in here. Our ink is textile, and it dries quicker and it hardens. We don't have to have that top pad in there. We can remove the top pad and simply go with the pad that's underneath that one.